Have you ever spent a good 20 minutes of your life completing a tough mission and then right at the end of it, whee! I fucking love this game. This game is great.
Oh my mama, oh my who, I look fly, yeah. I look good, touch my sway, baby. I look fly, yeah. I look good,
ragged on since a kid, how will I survive?
Alright, if I just ended the review there, it would still be legitimate. But what if I told you there's other stuff than flying tanks and terrible game physics? What if I told you there's 2001 voice acting?
Senor Dickhead!
Well, I got news for you. Shooting you will be a pleasure, but dating you was only business. Ooh-wee!
Oh, papa.
Oh! Ah! Ah!
You've got objective-based missions with NPCs and an M16 that can shoot 60 bullets in 0.3 seconds. And no, I'm not exaggerating. We got police that will murder hundreds and drive into certain death if it means even making a dent in your car. This cop gets run over by a cop, and naturally I can see how that was actually my fault. Now call me a bit of a victim blamer, but I think we need to ask some important questions here. When he got killed, where was the cop standing? If women enter the passenger seat and you drive to a remote location, your car may start bumping, at which point you'll magically regenerate health and lose money. This allows your health to go all the way up to 125. Now, if the passenger was to get in an unfortunate car accident, they would happen to have on them the exact amount of money that mysteriously disappeared from your wallet. And generally speaking, if you like games from the era before they really knew how to make them, then this is certainly the game for you. GTA 3 comes factory packed with motion blur and frame interpolation, along with the worst gun aiming humanity's ever devised. In fact, let's just get it out of the way. This game has aged like the milk on my wall. Very poorly. Yet, much like the death mold that deemed my apartment legally unfit for human life, the game has an intrinsic charm to it, and with only 14 different mods, it's actually semi-playable on PC. The formula is extremely simple. The game revolves around you driving around, killing and looting, getting into a bigger and bigger conflict with the law. Ranging from a minor crime at 1 stars to being hunted down by tanks and the Kalashnikov wielding FBI at 6 stars. If at all possible, avoid driving into the tanks. The missions is actually the side content you go through to unlock new areas and so that the actual gameplay doesn't get repetitive. Speaking of the core gameplay, it's actually really fucking good. You can instigate a literal gang war without coming into conflict with the law. But make one tiny scratch in the side of a police car, and within minutes, you'll have the FBI and entire armed forces hunting you down for your severe crime against humanity. We've got 8-bit facial textures and dummy-thick NPC coding, which I actually prefer. They'll follow me anywhere. I jump into the water and drown, he jumps into the water and drowns. I drive over the bridge held up by the FBI, he drives over the bridge held up by the FBI. I decide to practice Muay Thai on him because there's no exit mission feature. It turns out, he's exceptional at hand-to-hand combat. GTA 3 has hands down the best radio in any video game I've ever played.
Ah, just like Fellini's Lolita. Innocent, yet endlessly corrupting.
But seriously, this is the granddaddy of modern GTA games, and along with San Andreas, some of my most formative games growing up. I remember all this shit, like the spectrum of ways to get a tank. The quickest is of course a cheat code, but that's preschool baby mode. You could also complete every mission in the game, but that's honestly just a bad investment. No, what you really want to do is get to this mission where there's a locked tank. You're then gonna want to push it all the way across the city to your home. Running into the tank causes immense vehicle damage. Once you make it, you want to push that bad boy into your garage. Save and voila, they just turned a boy into a man. The fourth and absolute most respectable way to get a tank is to go on a tear and destroy everything till you get a 6-star wanted level, at which point it's technically possible to steal a tank, although it's nearly fucking impossible to get 6 stars. Taking this sandbox to its limits is brutally difficult, and I question whether that's by design or lack thereof. When a vehicle in GTA 3 is turned upside down, it becomes a car bomb. Vehicles flip over very easily, and you've got a fuck ton of plot armor. Whilst exiting, entering, or driving in a vehicle, you're entirely immune to bullets. You can, however, at any given time be arrested point blank by a police officer, even in a tank or if he dies while arresting you. And it's a real 50-50 if you choose to sprint on an edged surface.
That was magnificent.
GTA 3 really has it all. It's set in definitely not New York, right next to definitely not Staten Island. No, it's Staunton Island, which is the much nicer area you'll get to later in the game. One of the many parts of GTA 3 that doesn't reflect reality. Another trick if you want to go to Shoreside Vale before you unlock it is you can just grab a boat. Now there's these giant barriers as to stop you from going there, so I drive this bad boy ashore and go the distance. Right here at the end of my journey, I actually didn't regret how I'd spent the last 10 minutes of my life. It was only after I forgot to get in the boat that it dawned on me that deep down I truly wish I could have those 10 minutes back. This game is a bit like gambling. Whenever it steals 10 minutes of my life, I make up for it by spending another 20. Here's the bottom line. According to the Wikipedia for this game, it boasts first-person shooting with several weapons. And according to the dialogue,
they've been selling spank through the street stalls.
It's about Colombian street gangs selling spank through coffee machines. Personally, I disagree entirely. This game isn't about pushing spank. It's about pushing tank. On a serious note, the way they designed this game actually fucks with me. The tab targeting is incomprehensibly bad, and to top it off, the aiming and sensitivity of the three weapons that allow it are all vastly different. The only thing they have in common is that it's appalling. If not for the insurmountable recoil, the M16 would be the best gun in any game. Luckily for the NPCs, they don't have recoil. I tried and don't understand how it's humanly possible to complete the sniper missions with a controller. There's this mission where you gotta get some cars into a garage in pristine condition. They make you drive slower as to not hit anything. When you inevitably slightly touch anything, it turns out the pay-in spray to fix the car and lose the cops is right fucking next to the garage for the car. Now I'm pressured on time, and it's really starting to stress me out how slow the fastest vehicle in the game drives in reverse. If there's one thing to take away, it's that this game has made me dearly regret following the law and driving orderly. GTA 3 missions are the cinnamon coke zero of objective-based video game design. They make you drive to the other island to pick up a secret package in an airplane. They didn't tell you that the airplane was surrounded by gang members. I die and spawn in the hospital for Shoreside Vale, making me drive all the way back to accept the mission. Then, go all the way back to the airport, manage to take out the enemies. Now, they make you drive all the way back to the other island to this construction site. I carefully use the precision controls to take out this guy, and also this guy. Because I'm not doing this mission over again. I'm not doing all that shit again. What they don't inform you of is that there's hit-scan enemies with automatic weapons right around the corner. So naturally, you gotta do it all over again. And guess what? Every fucking time you drive to the goddamn fucking airport, it's RNG and how they're standing and they just fucking shoot your car. Fuck! This game is the first time I've ever appreciated that other games have fast travel. By the way, don't try to fly the airplane. It was not meant to be flown. Or what about this shit? Go take this boat and move at a snail's pace all the way out to this marker. Now, you gotta wait and shoot down an airplane. Like the seasoned GTA veteran I am, I had a better idea. I drive the boat onto this concrete square and effectively dispose of the enemies using the patented precision controls. Once the airplane approaches, I nail that shit first try and jump in the boat, only to realize the airplane drops these packages that I had to pick up. I'm low health as fuck and there's a chopper shooting at me. By some dark magic, I actually managed to make this glitchy ass jump, then somehow dodge every bullet from the chopper, only to die because I ran on top of the package I was supposed to pick up. On my fifth attempt, I actually managed to nail the plane again. With the precision turning, I pick up all the packages, and then my game crashes for no apparent reason. As I finally complete the mission on my 12th attempt, I feel a bit scummed out, considering I literally did it on my first fucking try. What infuriates me about the missions in GTA 3 is not that they're difficult by design, it's that I have to do them over and over again for a fucking eternity. All because the game crashed or because the gun aiming was coded on a maxi pad. When I actually get around to dying to all the bullshit they intended, I've already completed the mission several times over. God, I hate this game. I hate it so much. Go buy it now, but fuck do I hate this game. Seriously. Buy the bundle with Vice City and San Andreas, give Rockstar your money, and at the same time, unironically, Lord, I despise this vile creation. Escort mission. Follow this dumb fuck who drives half as fast as my grandma. With no sense of urgency, drive all the way through the underground, only for the van to get shot immediately when exiting on the other side. I retry this scumfuck mission, and the bastard driving the escort yet again moves with no haste. 10 minutes later, right at the end of the mission, he gets stuck on a wall. This is all quite infuriating. The silver lining is that when the game works, it just fucking works.
Knowing nothing in life but to be legit. Don't quote me, boy, cause I ain't said shit.
Get the fuck out!
I'd gotten to the final mission in the game. I start off with only a pistol in the middle of 20 Colombian gang members armed to the teeth. I'm supposed to follow the chopper, then make my way through the most intense sequence of gunplay in the game. We're talking barricades, a multitude of vehicles, and hitscan laser NPCs armed with M16s, AK-47s, and for whatever reason, flamethrowers, all whilst a chopper rains down missile fire. It takes about 5 minutes to even restart the mission if you fail, and did I mention it's on a timer? Now, whilst that does sound very intriguing, I'd actually rather do anything else than going through the ninth circle of video game hell. At first, I tried scaling the wall behind the building using Rockstar's patented edged surface gameplay, yet they were smart enough to put an invisible wall as to prevent players from cheating. I humbly accepted defeat, after which I completed the game just like the developers intended. Nah.
But the truth sounds like a lie. Live to win, till you die. Till the light that's in your eyes. Live to win, take it all. Just keep fighting till you fall.
Now, I may not have gotten it on my first attempt. What if I told you that after 2 hours, I found out that I needed to activate a certain cutscene to even get to the part where I'm supposed to destroy the chopper. Destroy everything, almost all the way to the building, then go all the way back and attempt to hit the chopper with a flying tank. And what if I told you I did that over and over and over again until I'd spent a total 5 hours of my life before it finally happened. At which point it dawned on me that the chopper is an indestructible mission object that can only be activated by hitting it with a rocket launcher. And imagine my immeasurable disappointment when I then painstakingly, no bullshit, actually complete the game only to find that on the very last frame of the chopper blowing up, GTA 3 crashes.
No fucking way.
Here's the bottom line, gentlemen. Could pretty much every single glitch in the entire game be linked with the fact that I've unlocked the frame rate? Possibly. Could all the crashes be caused by the 14 different mods I have installed? Likely. And did I base my arbitrary rating entirely on whether or not the game lets you fly a tank into a chopper? Absolutely. 0 out of 10. This game is fucking trash. One of man's worst creations. Unexpectedly so, playing this game 17 years after its release has not rekindled my treasured childhood memory of it, but rather completely smeared shit all over the nostalgia I had for this game. Enough is enough. This is where I draw the fucking line.
So I opened up my computer, and this is my D drive. It's got my full GTA 3 install, including all my save data. And I'm thinking we're just gonna plop this bad boy right in here. Oh, it goes. Oh. Fuck. Oh.
Drawing me in and you kicking me out. Got my head spinning, no kidding. I can't pin you down. What's going on in that beautiful mind? I'm on your magical mystery ride. And I'm so dizzy, don't know what hit me, but I'll be alright. My head. Your perfect imperfections, give your all.